myself, Ranjit, assistant professor, working at St. Martin's Engineering College. Today, I would like to tell three different topics. Subject is Thermal Engineering 1. Okay? And next, this Thermal Engineering Subject 1 course objective is to apply the laws of thermodynamics to analyze air standard cycles, and to understand the evaluate the performance of the major components. First, the thermodynamic subject. The extent of thermodynamic subject is thermal engineering 1. In this, we apply the laws of thermodynamics and to analyze the air standard cycles. And means air standard cycles, different types of cycles are there. One is the Arnold cycle, and next one is the Diesel cycle, and third one is the Dual cycle, and fourth one is the Tegan cycle, and etc. And next, evaluate the performance analysis of the components. Components means in these IC engines, components like connecting rod, crank pin, and rod jumping, and camshaft, and like etc. And third point, system of IC engines and refrigeration cycles and their applications. In this, refrigeration cycles means bell column cycle and etc. Okay, and next slide is course of outcomes. At the end of the course, the students should be able to evaluate the performance of IC engines and compressors under the given operating conditions. Means evaluate the performance of the IC engines. Means to find the heat balance sheets and brake thermal efficiency and to find the indicate powers. And next point, apply the laws of thermodynamics. Means we apply the laws, first law of thermodynamics and second law of thermodynamics and third law of thermodynamics and fourth law, means zeroth law. And fourth point, understand the functionality of major components of IC engines. Means the major components, means connecting rod, camshaft and pistons, and effects of operating condition, their performance. This is the course outcomes, the thermal engineering 1. Next, I have explained in this part.
Start.
This is the syllabus of the thermal engineering 1. And first unit, IC engines. In this IC engines, classification and working principles of the 2-stroke and 4-stroke engines. And ignition type of lubrication systems and fuel properties of combustion stoichiometry. And second, first and second unit is the basic fundamental of IC engines. And in third unit, testing and performance. In testing means and performance, in this principles of operating, work required, isothermal efficiency, volumetric efficiency. In this third unit, we find the heat balance sheet and volumetric efficiency and isothermal efficiency. And unit 4, the unit 4 tells about the different type of compressors. In this, three types of compressors there. One is the rotary compressor, and next one is the dynamic compressor, and third one is the axial flow compressor. In this also we find the volumetric efficiency and isothermal efficiency, and we find the heat balance sheet. And next, fifth unit is the gas turbines. In this, we find the work efficiency, and this gas turbines depends upon the cycles. And that cycle is based on cycle. Okay? Classification of IC engines. The IC engines may be classified according to first point, type of the fuel. In this, petrol or diesel or gas or biofuel engines. And next point is the nature of thermodynamic cycle. The cycles are Otto cycle, diesel cycle and dual cycle. And etc. cycles are there. And the third point is the number of stroke per cycle. Number of stroke per cycle is the 4-stroke engine and 2-stroke engine. Okay? And the fourth point is method of ignition. First method is spark ignition engines, and next is the compression ignition engines. And the fifth point, method of cooling. method of cooling is, first point is the air cooled engines and second is the water cooled engines. And sixth point, speed of the engines. The speed of the engine is low speed of the engines and medium speed of engines and high speed of engines. And seventh point is number of cylinders. In this number of cylinders, we divided into two parts, single cylinder engines or multiple cylinder engines. And eighth point, position of the cylinders. The position of the cylinders first divided into the four categories. First one is the radial engines, and second one is the opposite cylinder engines, and third one is the inline engines, and fourth one is the opposite piston engines. Okay, now this is the examples. This is the V engine, this is the opposite piston engine, and this is the inline engine. This is the classification of the IC engine. Major the IC engines classified into two types, internal combustion engines and second one is the external combustion engine. And also we used in this thermal engineering one, two stroke petrol engine or four stroke petrol engine or four stroke diesel engine. And two stroke petrol engine depends upon the auto cycle, and four stroke CI engines depends upon the diesel cycle. Okay, and next slide is engine terminology. In this first point, bore, the inner diameter of the cylinder, inner diameter of the cylinder is called bore. It, we denoted the bore length equal to L. Bore length equal to L. And second is the stroke. Second one is the stroke. It is the linear distance traveled by the piston. It is the linear distance traveled by the piston when it moves from end point of the cylinder to outer end, end point of the cylinder to outer end. And the next point is dead center. The, in the vertical engines, the top position of the piston is called top dead center. The bottom position of the piston is called bottom dead center. And clearance volume. It is the volume contained between the piston and the cylinder held when the position is the top in the dead center. And next one, the stroke volume, we denoted into Vs, and clearance value we denoted to Vc. This is the model diagram. This is the TDC, top dead center. This is the BDC, bottom dead center. When the piston moves upward, is called top dead center. When the piston placed in the bottom of the cylinder, is called bottom dead center. Okay, na? Stroke volume or shaft volume is denoted Vs. The Vs equal to 5 by 4 L into D square. 5 by 4 L into D square. Okay, and next. Okay, air standard cycles means Carnot cycle and Otto cycle, Dewar cycle and Etichon cycle and Stirling cycle. Okay, in this first cycle is the Otto cycle. In the Otto cycle, based on four process, first isentropic compression, and next one is the constant volume heat addition, and third one is the isentropic expansion, and fourth one is the constant volume heat rejection. Okay, in this process, isentropic compression, in this process, one and two process, isentropic compression, in this air and fuel mixes in this combustion chamber, that time pressure is increased and also temperature also increased. And next, constant volume heat addition and isentropic expansion, and fourth one is constant volume heat rejection. And next, diesel cycle. This diesel cycle is based on the four process. First one is the isentropic compression. Next one is the constant pressure heat addition. Constant pressure heat addition. And third one is the isentropic expansion. And fourth one is the constant volume heat rejection. Constant heat rejection. When the SI engines, the compression ratio is 6 to 12. In the CI engines, compression ratio is the 16 to 22. The compression ratio denoted by R, R equal to Vc plus Vs by Ec, equal to 1 plus Vc, Vs by Ec, the compression ratio.
Start.
This is the model diagram of the engine. First of all, this is the cam shaft, and this is the cam, and this is the inlet valve. in this inlet valve mixture of air. And the next one is the, this is a combustion chamber, and this is a spark plug, and this is a valve spring, and the next is the exhaust valve, and cylinder head, and cooling water, and this is the piston. The piston moves top dead center to bottom dead center. When the piston moves bottom dead center to top dead center, that time compression in the combustion chamber, the time compression is there. In this, the time pressure is increased. Pressure is increased. And next, this is the cylinder block. This is the connecting rod. This, when the connecting rod rotates in one stroke in power stroke, this is called the two-stroke engine. When the connecting rod revolution two strokes in the power stroke, it's called the four-stroke engine. Okay? And this is the inlet valve. When the air is comes to combustion chamber, and the time fuel also mixed, the time some of compression is there, the time pressure is increased. When the pressure is increased, the sample.